Good afternoon guys, welcome back to HashLearn. Myself Aman Kumar, I am your physics faculty for JEE NEET 2020. So in today's class I am going to talk about the collision of bodies, between two bodies, between three bodies, between multiple bodies. Okay, so I am just waiting for your comments so that I will start today's session. I hope your study is going well. We have lot of time to improve ourselves, so don't think that the time is very less. We have lot of time. If you have just started from today, you can start from today also to prepare for IIT JEE and NEET. Okay, you can do it now. Now I'm just waiting for a few comments. Like till now, there is no any comments from your side. So fine. Let's have a few recap of the previous class. What we have discussed in the previous class. So in the previous class, we discussed about the center of mass of continuous bodies. And what was continuous bodies? What is the formula for that? For continuous bodies, we can find that x center of mass, that is x coordinate of center of mass, equal to the integration of x dm upon integration of dm. And what is dm? Dm is the mass of small particle inside the body or inside the continuous body, inside the rod, inside the disc, inside the ring. It can be any type of mass. Understood? Then we discuss problem based on the center of mass, and then in that case we discuss few concepts. It was a very important concept, that is m1 r1 equal to m2 r2. You can apply this formula anywhere. If particle is at rest, or if a combination of particle is at rest, its center of mass will not change. Its center of mass will not change. Then we discuss conservation of momentum. What was conservation of momentum? If there is no any external force acting on the block, in that case what will happen? Net external force equal to 0. It means its linear momentum will always be conserved. There is a conservation of linear momentum. For example, explosion of bomb. If bomb is exploded in 2 or 3 parts, what will happen? Its linear momentum will conserve. Why? Because dekho, during explosion of bomb, you are not applying any external force. Getting my point? During explosion of bomb, you are not applying any external force. Only internal forces is acting on inside the bomb, and because of this, it's explode. And in that case, net external force equal to 0. In that case, you can apply this conservation of linear momentum. That is, momentum before explosion equal to momentum after explosion. And this type of question you can get it in your book. Many questions you can see in the book only. There is explosion of bomb, three parts, four parts, two parts, and two parts are moving with a velocity v1 and v2, having a magnitude of 2 m/s, 3 m/s. Find the magnitude of third part, find the magnitude of velocity of third part. This type of question you can expect in your exam also. Now I was going through your previous CPP, and I found that most of you done this mistake in the previous question or previous CPP. What is that? A particle is on a straight line motion with uniform velocity. A force is not required. See what is given. Particle is moving on a straight line. Suppose this is a particle. It's moving with a uniform velocity. What is meaning? What is the meaning of uniform velocity? U equal to constant. It means velocity is not changing. See, if velocity is not changing, in that case, du upon dt will be 0. And what is du upon dt? Rate of change of velocity with respect to time. That is equal to acceleration. And here, acceleration is also 0 because du is 0, because u is constant. So, du equal to, that is change in velocity will be 0. So, here acceleration is 0. It means there is no any force acting on the block. Because agar if acceleration is 0, force equal to mass into acceleration, and here force equal to 0, in that case, now a force is not required to increase the speed, to decrease the speed, to keep the same speed. Up here you can see that here already particle is moving with a uniform velocity. It means speed is constant or velocity is constant. In that case, a force is not required to keep the same speed. Understood? Because particle is already moving with a same speed. There is no need acceleration, so no need to put any external force on the particle. I hope everyone understood what was the right answer for this one. It should be C. Okay, so let's have a goal of the today class. So in today class, we're going to talk about the introduction of collision. What is the collision? It's a very interesting topic. Then we will discuss types of collision. Then I will discuss elastic collision. Then I will do few problems. That is very important. Okay, so let's start with the first topic, that is introduction of collision. So what do you understand by collision? That is a very interesting topic and it's a very easy one. I hope from your childhood everyone see this collision. For example, suppose I have two blocks. These two are blocks. They are moving with a velocity. Suppose this is the velocity of u1 and this is the velocity of this block having a velocity of u2. These are moving towards each other. After some time, what will happen? They will strike each other. They will strike each other, and this phenomena is known as collision. But see, in collision, there is not needed that either there is physical contact with the two particles. There is not required either physical contact of between two particles. Why? See, suppose I have two magnets. I will just take two. Again, I will take this one. Suppose this is one magnet and this is another magnet. What will happen? I'm just keeping this magnet here. I'm just moving this magnet towards there. Now, suppose that this is a north pole and this is also a north pole. So this north pole will repel this magnet because similar poles repel each other. You can see that similar poles repel each other. So here this magnet will repel this magnet. And suppose that this is a south pole and this is a north pole. So when you will move this magnet towards the south pole, this will attract each other. In that case also, this is a kind of phenomena of that is known as collision. This is also another kind of phenomena that is known as collision. So now, what is the definition of collision? See, collision between two bodies is said to be occur when they either physically strike against each other, that is the case of this one, they will collide, or if the path of the motion of one is influenced by the other, or path of the one particle is influenced by the motion of other. Understood? In collision, there is no need of physical, there is not always required the physical contact, physical strike. This is not required always. So what is, or you can say that if the motion of one particle is influenced by the motion of other particle, then also we can say that this is the phenomena that is known as collision. If the motion of one particle is affected by the motion of another particle, that is also an example of collision. What is the reason for this influence? If the motion of one particle is influenced by the motion of other particle, what is the cause of this influence? For example, this influence is, the cause of this influence can be any type. For example, suppose gravitational force, nuclear force, magnetic force, electrostatic force. For example, suppose this is a one charge, that is Q1, positive charge, and this is another charge, that is minus Q1. What will happen? Because of this, suppose this is minus Q2, this Q1 will attract this one, or this minus Q2 will attract Q1. So in this case also, there will be a case of collision. Because why? Because this Q2 will try to just call, it will try to move this Q1 towards Q2, and Q1 will try to move towards Q2. So this is also a case of collision. Take another example. Suppose this is Q1 and here one charge is there, that is Q2. Both are positive sign. What will happen? This Q2 is moving towards Q1, and because of this movement, this Q2 will just repel Q1, because they both having a same nature of charge, and you know that the similar charges will repel each other. So in this case also we can say that this is another case of collision. Understood? So two things we have learned in collision. First one is during collision, motion of one particle is influenced by the motion of another particle. That is the first point. And second point is not always physical contact is required or physical strike is required during the collision. Second point. Now see, suppose two particles are here, they are moving towards each other. Suppose this is velocity u1 and this is velocity u2, and after some time they will collide with each other, right? So what is happening? Either in this case, you are not applying any external force on the bodies, they are moving towards, there is no any external force, but they will exert equal and opposite forces on each other during collision. Suppose this is the during collision, they will exert equal and opposite forces on each other. So what type of forces they are exerting? What type of forces they are applying on each other? So we can say that this is a contact forces. Suppose this is block M1 and this is block M2. So here suppose this is M1. So on M1, M2 will apply a force, that is suppose this is N1, and on M2, this M1 will apply a force, that is N1, and both are in opposite direction. So on these two blocks, they are exerting equal and opposite forces on each other, and that is contact force and that is internal force. Understood? That is internal force. So in collision, we can say that there is no any external forces, only internal forces are acting. Understood what I am saying? कि ड्यूरिंग कोलिजन देर इज नो एनी एक्सटर्नल फोर्स, ओनली इंटरनल फोर्सेज आर एक्टिंग. एंड वी जस्ट नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास कि इफ देर इज नो एनी एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेज ऑन द ब्लॉक, मोमेंटम ऑफ द बॉडी विल कंजर्व. इफ देर इज नो एनी एक्सटर्नल फोर्स ऑन द ब्लॉक, मोमेंटम ऑफ द बॉडी विल कंजर्व. तो हियर वी कैन से दैट ड्यूरिंग द कोलिजन ऑलवेज मोमेंटम ऑफ द बॉडी विल कंजर्व. ड्यूरिंग कोलिजन ऑलवेज मोमेंटम ऑफ द बॉडी विल कंजर्व. तो हियर यू कैन राइट दैट ड्यूरिंग कोलिजन मोमेंटम ऑफ बॉडीज, यू कैन राइट सिस्टम ऑल्सो विल कंजर्व. ओके, सो दिस इज अ की पॉइंट फॉर कोलिजन. नाउ types of collision, how many types of collision we have, because I have already gave you the examples of collision also. If two bodies are here, they will strike against each other. If there are two charges, they will repel each other, that is also a kind of collision, because the motion of one particle is influenced by the motion of another particle. Take as a magnetic, you can take magnetic force also, because see, in magnetic force what will happen, if there are two magnets, if you are just placing two magnets against each other, you are just moving two magnets against each other, what will happen? If they having a similar pole, they will repel each other. If they having a unsimilar poles or dissimilar poles, they will attract each other. That is also a kind of collision. Now, how many types of collision we have? So that is also a very important part, that how many types of collision we have. So basically, we have two types of collision. That is, we can write two types of collision. First one is elastic collision, second type is inelastic collision. First one is elastic collision, second one is inelastic collision. So what do you understand by elastic collision? So see, in elastic collision, first of all we have studied about the collision, there is always conservation of momentum. So always remember ki whenever we talk about the collision, we always do this conservation of momentum. What is the conservation of momentum? It means ki initial momentum of the system equal to final momentum of the system. Understood? Total initial momentum equal to total final momentum. Now in case of this elastic collision, if two bodies are just striking against each other or striking with each other, we assume that if the force acting is conservative, if the force acting on the two block is conservative, in that case total mechanical energy will conserve. Already I told you in the previous classes, if the force acting on the block is only conservative, total mechanical energy will conserve. In that case, what is the mechanical energy? It is summation of kinetic energy plus potential energy. But we just assume that ki particle is moving on the same height or same base, just like this one. So its moment, its change in potential energy will be zero, because it is at the same height. So only we have kinetic energy, change in kinetic energy. So here we can say that in elastic collision, the kinetic energy will also conserve, momentum will also conserve. There is a conservation of kinetic energy as well as conservation of momentum. Then that collision is known as elastic collision. Always remember, whenever we talk about the elastic collision, there is always conservation of kinetic energy as well as conservation of momentum. So here we can say that in elastic collision, conservation of kinetic energy. So we can say that ki momentum initial equal to momentum final. Momentum initial equal to momentum final. One more thing you can write here, that is kinetic energy initial equal to kinetic energy final. But here always remember that this kinetic energy is the total energy, total kinetic energy of the system. That is kinetic energy of block 1 plus kinetic energy of block 2 at initial phase or at initial point. This kinetic energy final is the kinetic energy of block 1 plus kinetic energy of block 2 at final point. Understood? After collision, you can, or you can say that this kinetic energy final is the summation of kinetic energy of individual body after collision, and this kinetic energy initial equal to, I'm just writing here, this kinetic energy initial is total kinetic energy before collision. I'm just kinetic energy final equal to after collision. So this is the introduction about elastic collision. Now second one is inelastic collision. So what do you understand by inelastic collision? See, in elastic collision there was a conservation of kinetic energy, but for inelastic collision there is no any conservation of kinetic energy. Kinetic energy will lost during collision. And what are the examples of inelastic collision and what are the examples of elastic collision? So for elastic collision, suppose there are two blocks, they are moving towards each other, after t time they will strike against each other, and they either this block will come to rest or either this block will come to rest, or they will move with a different speed. That is the case of elastic collision. But what about inelastic collision? See, there is a block, suppose there is a block and there is a gun. So I'm just striking this gun, what will happen? Bullet will come from this gun and it is just strike this object, and assume that ki after striking it will embed into this object, and then they will move together. So that is the example of inelastic collision, or you can say that perfectly inelastic collision. I will discuss sometime after sometime or in the next class ki what is the perfectly elastic collision, what is perfectly inelastic collision. These things I will discuss in the next class. Okay, so just now understand ki during inelastic collision there is no any conservation of kinetic energy. So here we can write that in elastic collision conservation of momentum, and there is no any conservation of momentum. For inelastic collision, conservation of momentum only, there is no any conservation of kinetic energy. So here we can say that no conservation of kinetic energy. Dekho, during solving the problem you can apply this condition ki dekho, in inelastic collision what you can write, momentum initial equal to momentum final. But kinetic energy, total kinetic energy, you can write total kinetic energy initial not equal to total kinetic energy final. Understood? Here initial kinetic energy will not be equal to final kinetic energy in case of inelastic collision. Now I will discuss what is elastic collision. I will discuss in the brief. See, suppose there are two objects, there are two blocks moving towards each other. It's moving with a velocity of u2, having a mass of m2. Here this block having moving with mass of m1, moving with velocity u1. See, and we assume that this u1 is greater than u2. What we are assuming? So consider, we are just considering two blocks having masses m1 and m2, having a velocity of initial velocity u1 and u2, masses m1 m2, and here we are just assuming that u1 is more than u2. What will happen? See, the block of one, the velocity of one block is more than velocity of other block, and they are moving in same direction. So after some time, what will happen? After some time, this mass m1 will strike with m2. Kaise? Suppose there are two blocks. it is moving with a slower speed as compared to this one. So this will reach fast and will strike, it will strike here. So after some time, suppose there is a collision, this is the case of collision, this is M1 and this is M2. So this is during collision, you can write this is during collision and this is before collision. Ab dekho, after collision what will happen? Their velocity will change. This is another block. The size of the block now it's got increase. During collision size of the object will be same. Don't think that it will increase or decrease. So see, and here after collision what will happen? Their velocity will change. So here the velocity of M2 will V2 and the velocity of M1 is P1, that is M1, that is M2. Assume that the mass, this is mass A and this is mass B, here it is A, here it is B, again it is here A, here it is B. So here you can see that after collision their velocity is changing, right? It's become V1 and it's become V2 from U1 and U2. Now we can say that this is a case of collision, so its momentum will conserve, its momentum will conserve. So for, you can write for collision, initial momentum equal to final momentum. So here we can write m1 u1. I'm just taking the in vector form, m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 in vector form. See, this is the initial momentum, that is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. This is the final momentum, m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Up here you can see that both the blocks are moving in same direction, in one dimensional motion. They are doing one directional motion or one dimensional motion. What is the meaning of one dimensional motion? That is motion in only one direction. They are moving in the same direction. So I can take only the magnitude of all the velocity, because the sign is always same, because that is moving in the same direction after collision also. See, this is the collision. After collision they are moving in the same direction, understood? So here I can say that m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. But here you can see that this m1 plus m2 equal to, or you can write m1 u1. See, here m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So this convert this m1 move this m1 v1 in left side and this m2 u2 in right side. What you will get? You will get m1 u1 minus v1 equal to m2 here only, m1 v2 minus u2. This you will get, that is equation number 1. And we are considering that this collision is an elastic collision. So in that case what will happen? Kinetic energy will conserve. This is the example of elastic collision. So we will do this one also. This kinetic energy will conserve. In that case what will happen? Half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square equal to how much? That is half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. See, now just again can I do this one? Half it will get cancelled out, you will get m1 u1 square minus v1 square equal to m2 v2 square minus u2 square. This is equation number 2. Can I do this one 2 by 1? 2 by 1 and here you will get, see, m1 u1 square minus v1 square divided by m1 u1 minus v1, that is equal to m2 v2 square minus u2 square divided by m2 V2 minus U2. Sorry, it should not be U2 square. Now, see, this is A square minus B square, U1 square minus V1 square, we can write U1 plus V1, U1 minus V1, can I say how? See, I am just doing here, can I say U1 square minus V1 square equal to U1 plus V1 multiply by the U1 minus V1. This is the case, can I say how? See, A square minus B square equal to A plus B multiply by A minus B. So, here you will get, see, U1 minus V1 and U1 minus V1, it will cancel out. M1 upon M1, it will also get cancelled out, M2 upon M2, it will get cancelled out. So, you will get U1 plus V1 equal to V2 plus U2, U2 plus V2 plus U2. So, here you can see U1 minus U2 equal to V2 minus V1. You can write U1 minus U2 equal to V2 minus V1. This is equation number 3. What is the meaning of this one? U1 minus U2 equal to V2 minus V1. Here you can see that initial, this is the relative motion, that is initial relative motion, U1 minus U2, and this V2 minus V1 is the final relative motion. And so here you can see that in case of elastic collision, in case of one dimensional elastic collision, the relative velocity of path of approach equal to relative velocity of path of separation. This is the separation because see, after collision they are separating, and during collision they are colliding with each other, but after collision they are separating. So, this is the case of separation, or you can write there this one separation, and this is the case of approach, understood. So, this is the case of separation after collision, and before collision that is the case of approach. So, here I can write keep velocity of path of separation approach equal, it should be relative velocity equal to relative path of separation. So, always remember in case of elastic collision, always relative velocity of path of approach equal to relative velocity of path of separation, that is relative velocity before collision equal to relative velocity after collision. Now we have to find the velocity after collision. What is the magnitude of velocity V1 and V2 after collision in terms of U1 and U2, M1 and M2. So, here we got one formula, that is U1 minus U2 equal to V2 minus V1. Just do one thing, can I say V2 equal to how much? V2 equal to U1 minus U2 plus V1, U1 minus U2 plus V1. And here from equation number 1, what was equation number 1? That is M1 U1. From equation 1, M1 U1 minus V1 equal to M2, it should be V2 minus U2. So, V2 minus U2. Just put on the values of V2 here. What you will get? M1 U1 minus V1 equal to M2. V2 is how much? That is U1 minus U2 plus V1 minus U2. Okay. Now, see U2 is U2 minus 2 U2. So, here you can see that M1 U1 minus M1 V1 equal to how much? That is M2 U1 minus plus M2 V1 minus 2 M2 U2. And see, we need to find the velocity V1 after collision. So, can I say this one M1 and here M2? So, you can write it here only. So, you can you will get is M1 plus M2. V1 equal to, I will just write the terms here, V1 equal to M1 minus M2 U1 plus 2 M2 U2. I am just rearranging all the terms, you will get this one. So, V1 equal to how much? V1 equal to M1 minus M2 U1 about divided by M1 plus M2 plus 2 M2 U2 upon M1 plus M2. So, this is the very important result after collision in in elastic collision, what is the magnitude of V1? That is velocity of mass 1 after collision, that is M1 minus M2 U1 upon M1 plus M2 plus 2 M2 U2 upon M1 plus M2. So, how you will remember this formula? See, first one is the difference and sum M1 minus M2, M1 plus M2 multiply by velocity U1 plus 2 times of M2 U2 upon M1 plus M2. So, M1 plus M2 is common in both sides, both the term. Only difference is first one is difference of masses into U1. So, second one is 2 times of second mass, that is 2 M2 U2. So, this is the first velocity, or you can say that velocity of mass 1, that is M1. Here it is, V1 equal to this one. How you can find the velocity V2? That is the, in that case for this one V2, I will just replace this one. Again V2 for this one, V1 equal to how much? V1 equal to V2 minus E1 plus U2. So, here I can say that V2 equal to how much? Sorry, it should be V1. So, V1 equal to how much? V1 equal to V2 plus U2 minus E1. U2 minus U1. Kaise see? Here V1 equal to V2 minus E1 plus U2. It should be, we are calculating V1, that V2 minus U1 plus U2, plus U2, I am just doing this one, right, minus U1, yes, okay, fine, and just put on the values of this one in equation number 1, you will get M1, equation number 1 is M1 U1 minus V1 equal to M2 V2 minus U2, put on the values of V1 here only, you will get M1, and you will get the final answer, just that's 2 U1 minus V2 minus U2 equal to how much? Equal to M2 V2 minus U2. Now, after solving these two things, after rearranging these two terms, you will get value of 2 M1 U1 minus M1 V2 minus M1 U2 equal to M2 V2 minus M2. Which is getting cut, so you will write M2 V2 minus M1 M2 U2. See what I am doing, I am just putting the values of V1 here. So, you will get value of V1 here, 2 U1, why U1? Because after this is a minus sign, so you will get plus U1. So, U1 and plus U1, that is 2 U1 minus U2 minus V2. Why V2? Because it is a minus sign minus U2 plus minus minus equal to M2 V2 minus U2. Understood? And just rearrange the all the terms, you will get 2 M1 U1. Minus M1 V2 minus M1 U2 equal to M2 V2 minus M2 U2. I'm just, see here we are getting in the left side M1 V2 and in the right side M2 V2. So, either you can move this M1 V2 in left right side, or you can move M2 V2 in left side. So, you will get this one M1 plus M2 V2 equal to 2 M1 U1 minus M1 U2 plus M2 U2. Here I am getting this one 2 M1 U1 minus M1 U2 plus M2 U2 equal to this one. So, from here you can see V2 equal to how much? V2 equal to 2 M1 U1 upon M1 plus M2 plus M2 minus M1 U2 upon M1 plus M2. So, this is the velocity of second block after collision. So, here you can write this is velocity of mass M2 after collision. So, this is the velocity of mass 2 after collision, that is V2 equal to 2 M1 U1 upon M1 plus M2 plus M2 minus M1 upon M1 plus M2 U2. These two are very important results, just remember this two results, that is here in only V2 and V1, that is very important. I think it is a contest time. So, in the previous context, I asked about the work done by a frictional force, and see, always remember one thing, friction is always acting in the back side, in the opposite side of the motion sometime. So, here we can say that this is the Fs and motion is in this direction. So, always it will be negative. Why? The angle will be force and the displacement is always 180 degree. So, it will be negative, and the winner name of the previous contest is Arshad Khan. So, Arshad, very congratulations, you are getting one item session. Now, contest question is coming on the screen, that is here only. If vector i minus 3j plus 5k and i minus 3j minus ak are equal vectors, then the value of a is how much? Just try to do this one. next topic, that is only the inelastic collision. So till now we got this formula, that is V1 equal to M1 minus M2 U1. So I will just summarize here, V1 equal to M1 minus M2 U1 divided by M1 plus M2 plus 2M2 U2 upon M1 plus M2. This is velocity of 1. What is velocity of 2? That is, you can write M2 minus M1, that is U2 divided by M1 plus M2 plus 2M1 U1 upon M1 plus M2. See, what is the difference here? For V1, M1 minus M2 U1. For V2, M2 minus M1 U2. Understood? That is M2 minus M1 U2. For this is for V1, this is for V2. And here 2 M2 U2 because we are finding V1, so I will take as M2 U2. We are finding here V2, that is I will take M1 U1. In this way, you can find, you can remember this formula. For V1, this is a difference of M1 minus M2. For V2, there is a difference of M2 minus M1. And here we are finding V2, so it will be U2. Here we are finding V1, so it will be U1 plus. Up here we are finding the V1. So I will take the just opposite of the velocity of second block, that is M2 U2 plus M1 plus M2. And here for V2, this will be M1 U1. Understood? Now, special cases. Special cases, that is very important for exams. First one, if colliding bodies having equal masses. What is the meaning of this equal masses? It means, can I say M1 equal to M2? Yes, it should be equal, both the bodies having equal masses, that is M1 equal to M2. In that case, what will happen? Now, what is the velocity V1? Dekho, here when you will put M1 equal to M2, this term will 0, M1 minus M2 will be 0. So, you will get 2 M2 U2 divided by M1 plus M2, and here we will get, and here also see 2 M2 U2, and assume that this is equal to M, because both are both having equal mass, so you will get 2 M U2 upon 2 M, because M1 plus M2, that is M plus M, that is 2 M. So you will get 2 M2 M will get cancelled out, you will get V1 equal to U2. V1 equal to U2. What about this V2? So for V2, I can say again, see M2 minus M1, that is M minus M, that is equal to 0. So you will get 2 M U1 upon 2 M. Again, 2 M2 M will get cancelled out, you will get U1. So in case of when the two masses having equal, two objects having equal masses, they are colliding with each other. In that case, what will happen after collision? V1 equal to U2. And V2 equal to U1. See, what is the meaning of this one? Suppose there are two equal masses, they are colliding with each other. In that case, what will happen? They will just interchange their velocity. They will just interchange their velocity. Kaise? See, if suppose there are two equal blocks, suppose this is M and this is also M, velocity is U1, velocity is U2. This is before collision. And after that, after collision, see, suppose this is the after collision. This is block this one and this is block this one. So after the collision, what will happen? They will just interchange their velocity. So this is block 1, suppose this is block A and this is block B. This is A and this is B. So here after collision, velocity will be U2 and here it will be U1. So always remember one thing. Whenever two bodies are colliding with each other having equal masses, they will just interchange their velocity. So there is no need to solve the velocity, no need to find the velocity after collision through this formula, previous formula, this one. You can easily say that they will interchange their velocity. Understood? Now, second case. Suppose, assume that M2 is at rest. Sorry. M2 is at rest. In that case, what will happen? When M2 is at rest, can I say U2 equal to 0? u2 equal to 0. In that case, what will v1 equal to how much? Velocity after collision. Case, suppose this is the case and this is the block, that is m2, and here u2 equal to 0, it is at rest, and this m1 block, that is here, is moving towards u2 with a velocity of u1. So after collision, this is the case of before collision. So after collision, what will happen? V1 equal to how much? V1 equal to, see here you are just saying that u2 equal to 0. In that case, m1 minus m2 u1. So v1 equal to m1 minus m2 u1 divided by m1 plus m2, and v2 equal to how much? V2 equal to 2 m1 u1 upon m1 plus m2. Why I am writing this one? See, for v2 we have formula this m2 minus m1 u2 upon m1 plus m2 2 m1 u1 upon this one. So u2 is 0. So if u2 is 0, you will get v2 equal to 2 m1 u1 upon m1 plus m2. So here I am just writing this formula. Up here in this second case, when m2 is at rest, we have three special sub cases. See, first one, if two masses, two blocks having equal masses and second mass is at rest. See what I am saying, if two blocks having equal masses and second block is at rest. So here we are assuming that, in this case we are assuming this is block 1 and this is block 2. Suppose this is B block and this is A block, and mass is M and M, and the second block, that is at rest, and here it is moving with a U1. In that case, you have to find the velocity V1, velocity V2. How we will find this velocity V1 and V2? See, for V1 and V2, what I will do? I will do, put on the values here. So here M1 minus M2, that is equal to 0. So you will get V1 equal to 0. What about V2? For V2, I will write 2m u1 upon m1 plus m, m plus m, that is 2m. So here I can say that 2m u1 upon m plus m. So here you will get 2m and 2m, it will get cancelled out, you will get u1. So see, if two bodies are striking against each other and having equal masses, and if the second block is at rest, in that case they will just interchange their velocity. So here v1 equal to 0, the final velocity after collision of block 1 will be 0. Final velocity of block 2 after collision, it will be initial velocity of block 1. Understood? See, just if you want to note down, just note down here. So v1 equal to 0, v2 equal to u1. Understood? Now I think time is over now, so I will discuss few problems here. See, in the first problem, what is given? In a spring gun having spring constant 100 newton meter, a small ball of mass 0.1 kg is put in its barrel by compressing the spring through a 0.05 as shown in the figure. See, this is a block and you are just compressing this spring by 0.05, and you are just releasing this spring. What will happen? When you will compress this spring, spring will have one potential energy, that is spring potential energy, half kx square, and when you will release this spring, this elastic potential energy, that is half kx square, will convert into kinetic energy. It will just give the all the elastic potential energy to block, that will convert into kinetic energy. So here we can say that half kx square equal to half mv square. So from here you can find the value of velocity, that is v equal to under root k by m into x. Put on the values here, k is given 100 newton per meter divided by mass is 0.1 under root into x. X is how much? That is 0.05. So you will get some values here, under root I think 5 by 3 or something you will get. Now, so this is the value of velocity, that is first point, find the velocity of the ball when the spring is released. Second point, where should a box be placed on the ground so that the ball falls in it if the ball lifts the gun horizontally at a height of 2 meter above the ground. So height is given, that is 2 meter, and here suppose this is the point B. So at B point, you can see that ball is having only one component of velocity, that is along the horizontal direction. There is no any component of velocity in vertical direction. So here we can say that in y direction there is no any initial velocity. Understood? So can I say this one, y equal to u y t plus half gt square. Acceleration is how much? That is gravity, that is g, and here it is 0. So how much time it will take to reach from B point to this one at this point? That is t. So t equal to under root 2 h by g. Put on the values here, 2 into 2 divided by 10, you will get under root 2 by 5, and here you will get under root 5 by 2. Now we got time taken by the ball to reach from B point to, on suppose this is A point, from B to A. And now what is asking? Find the, where should a block box be placed on the ground. It means you have to find the value of d. So can I say d equal to how much? That is ux into t, because in x direction there is no any force is acting. So it is the case of projectile motion. That is, in the case of projectile, we can say that the projectile when vertical, for vertical projectile motion we have studied that this t equal to ux into, sorry, d equal to ux into t. So here we can write d equal to ux into t. That is how much? Under root 5 by 2 into under root 2 by 5. Dekho, why I am doing this one? Can I say s equal to how much? That is ut, s equal to ut plus half at square, and in x direction there is no any acceleration. Understood? So this a equal to 0 in x direction. So here you will get s equal to ut, that is t equal to ux into. So here we will get 1 meter. Understood? Now let's have a summary of today class. In today class we discuss about introduction of collision, then we discuss types of collision, then we discuss elastic collision, then we discuss few problems. That is one problem we discuss. So I hope today you have understood my today class. Okay, fine. It's a class practice back time, guys. I just prepared 10 most important problems that is very useful for your JEE and NEET preparation. So please go through my today class, today's CPP, that is very important. And for today's good luck, we will meet on Tuesday. Thank you so much. Take care.